Everyone, how are you, dear students? I hope you all are fine and doing well at home. Now again, it's time for maths lecture. So let us begin. In our previous lecture, we had started exercise 3.3. So we'll continue it today. No need to write exercise 3.3 again, as you had already written it. We had done question number 1 and question number 2 also in our last lectures. Okay, so today we are going to do word problems. Word problems we had done in chapter number 2 also. In chapter number 2, we could call it as addition stories also. We were learning addition there, or here we are learning subtraction. So here we can call it word problem as subtraction stories. Okay, here we can call word problems as subtraction stories too. Why we are calling it as subtraction story? Again, there is a scenario given to us, and then we have to find out something. So as they are giving us a scenario or a story, so we can call it a story, and we have to do subtraction. So we can call it subtraction stories. Now, like in addition, they were giving us some information, and we had to find out something by that information. Likewise, in subtraction stories too, some information will be given by the question, some information will be given by the question or the word problem, and by the information we have to find something. Some information will be given by the question, by the word problem or the subtraction story. Some information will be given in the question. With the help of that information, question will ask us to find something. Some information will be given, and we have to find something on the basis of the given information. So first of all, we will read the word problem very carefully. The very first rule of solving any kind of word problem, whether it is subtraction story or addition story, the very first rule is reading word problem very much carefully. When we'll read the word problem carefully, then we'll get what is the given information. Then we will write down the given information. Then we will find out what question is asking us to find. Then by doing addition or subtraction, we can solve the question. So let's move towards the exercise. Question number 1. Question number 1 of the word problems. 95 children of our school had ice creams. 95 children of our school had ice cream. See, there are 95 students and they all are having ice cream. 62 students had strawberry ice cream and the rest had chocolate. See, total 95 children are there. See, this is the given information. This is the given information by the question. Total 95 children are there. 62 students had strawberry ice cream, and this is also given information. Out of 95, 62 are having strawberry flavor, and the rest had chocolate ice cream. And out of 95, 62 are having strawberry flavor, and the rest of these children are having chocolate ice cream. How many children had chocolate ice cream? See, the question has given us some information. What is the given information? The total number of children, and there are two flavors of ice cream. cream, it means ice cream is divided into two groups. One is a strawberry flavor and another is chocolate. So total 95 children are there. Out of them, 62 are having strawberry. See, this is also the given information. Now, how many children had chocolate ice cream? See, this is, they are asking us to find the number of children they are having chocolate ice cream, okay? So, let's solve it. First of all, you all will write word problem. Note it down from the book. Exercise 3.3 word problems, page number 50. All of you open your book and copies also. Note down the word problems. See, I am not going to write the question, but you have to write question. I am giving you time. Note it down quickly. Once again, I am reading you for all. 95 children of a school had ice creams. 62 students had strawberry ice creams and the rest had chocolate ice creams. How many children had chocolate ice cream? Okay, so I hope you all had written the question. Let's start solving. So, after writing the whole word problem, we'll write solution. Then start solving. So, the very first step is the reading word problem carefully. Then start solving. And while solving, the very first step is writing the given information. So, let's start writing the given information. Number of children. So, let's write total children. How many? 95. So, we'll write 95. Here, let's write places 2. Sorry, not 100. Ones and tens. Only two numbers are there, so we'll write two places. Now, total children are 95. Now, strawberry. How many? How many children are having strawberry? 62. Had strawberry. So had a strawberry. How many? 62 children. Now we have to find how many are having chocolate. So for how many had chocolate? So for getting that, we'll subtract this strawberry. The number of children who are having strawberry flavor, we'll subtract it from the total children, okay? So let's subtract, starting from the ones. First of all, we'll subtract ones from ones. So 5 minus 2. See, you will not write 6 and minus in same box. The 6 and minus will be in different boxes, okay? So 5 minus 2. First of all, we'll open 5 fingers. We had opened 5 fingers now. Minus 2. Minus 2 is there. So we'll take away 1 and 2 fingers. Now how many left? 1, 2 and 3. 3 fingers are left. So we'll write the number 3. Now moving toward next column, that is 10. 9 minus 6. 9 minus 6. So first of all, we'll open 9 fingers. So raise your hand and start opening with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Minus 6. Minus 6 is there. So we'll take away now 6 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now how many fingers are left? Let's count them. 1, 2 and 3. 3 fingers are left. So we'll write the number 3. So 33 is our difference. So how many had chocolate ice cream? 33. Children had chocolate ice cream, okay? So, let's write answer. So, 33 children had chocolate ice cream. Now you can note down it. And be remember all of you, all the lines you are making, do use of scale or ruler. Make it with a scale or ruler. Do not use your running hand. So total 95 children were there. Out of them 62 were having strawberry ice creams. So how many had chocolate ice cream? Yes, 33 children had chocolate ice creams. So I hope now you all have noted down. If not, now you can take a screenshot or pause the video and write it later. Or I am providing you PDF, all of you, from there also you can write, okay? So now, moving towards next question, all of you read the word problem. Number 2, second word problem. There were 85 seats in an auditorium. If 74 people attended a concert held in the auditorium, how many seats were left? Okay, see, there are 85 seats in an auditorium. And 74 people attended a concert in the auditorium. So some seats were left in the auditorium. So the question is asking us to find how many seats were left. So first of all, let us find what is the given information. Read the first line. There were 85 seats in an auditorium. See, this is the information. Now, what is the another information given? 75 people attended a concert held in the auditorium. See, if 75 people have attended the concert, it means 74. If 74 people attended concert, it means 74 seats were occupied. But total 85 seats are there, some seats were left empty. So the question is asking us to find the number of seats which were left empty. Okay, so given information is the total seat and occupied seat. Okay, so first of all, let us write the given information. Total seats. All of you, first of all, write down the question in notebook. Okay, in classwork copy. Note down the question. I'm giving you some time, note it down. Note it down with good handwriting. Now I hope you all had noted down the question. So now we can start solving. So first of all, we'll write solution. Now all of you stop writing. First of all, we'll write about the number of total seats. So let's write it. Total seats. How many? 85. See, two digits are there, so we'll write two places. If three digits will be there, then how many places we'll write? Very good, then we'll write three places. So now let's write ones and tens, okay? Now, total seats, occupied seats. Now, we will write about occupied seats. How many seats were occupied? If 74 people attended, it means 74 seats will be occupied. If 74 people will come, then 74, they will take 74 seats. So, occupied seats are 74. Now, the empty seats. Question is asking us to find the number of empty seats. So, how we will find it? If we will subtract the occupied seats from the total number of seats, we will get the number of empty seats, okay? So, it's starting from the ones. Let's subtract ones from ones. So, 5 minus 4. So, first of all, we'll open 5 fingers. We had opened our 5 fingers. Minus 4. Minus 4 is there. So, we'll take away now 4 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many left? Only this one. So, we'll write the number 1. Now, 8 minus 7. We are done with tens column. Moving to, we are done with ones column. Now, moving toward tens. 8 minus 7. So, all of you, let us open 8 fingers first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, minus 7. Minus 7 is there. So, let's take away 7 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Only this one is left. So, again we will write the number 1. So, initially 85 seats were there in an auditorium. 74 people attended a concert. It means 74 seats were occupied by them. So, how many were left? 11 seats were left. So, let's write the answer. There were 11 seats left or empty. Anything we can write. Now, with this, we are done with this question. All of you, note it down properly. See, total in an auditorium 85 seats were there. Some people attended a concert. How many? 74. See, if 74 people will come, then they will take 74 seats. That is why we are writing occupied seats. If 74 will come, they will occupy 74. If 10 people will come, then they will occupy 10 seats. Okay. So, now we can get by subtracting the number of empty seats. So, there were 11 seats empty, or there were empty 11 seats. Note it down properly. Now you are done with this lecture, this question. Moving towards next. Now read the next question, that is question number 3, carefully. Read it properly. Yes. A school took 81 students to a science museum. There is a school. That school took some students to a science museum. If 29 students were boys, out of them some are boys and some are girls. So they had given us the number of boys. Now how many students were girls? See, they gave us a number of students. Then they told us about number of boys. Then the rest will be definitely girls. So the rest of the number they are asking us. Okay, so all of you note down the question properly. I'm giving you a little time, note it down. And if you are not able to note down in that time, you can pause the video and note down. Now I hope this much time is sufficient for you all. Now, what is the given information? The given information is the total students, the number of students. Then some of them are boys. So they had given us the number of boys also. Now what they are asking us to find? They are asking us to find number of girls. So let's write about the total students first. Solution, total student. First of all, we'll write about total students. What is the number of total student? 81. So we'll write number 81. Now once again, two places are there. So we'll write ones and tens. Now number of boys. How many are boys? 29. So now we had to find number of girls. So how we'll find the number of girls? If we'll separate number of boys from the total student, we'll get the number of girls. Okay, so let's subtract. Starting from the ones, 1 minus 9. 1 minus 9. Can we remove 9 from 1? Yes or no? Can we remove 9 from 1? Yes or no? No. Why? Why we cannot remove 9 from 1? Because 9 is the bigger number and 1 is the smaller number. And we always subtract smaller number from the bigger number. But here 9 is the bigger number. So we cannot remove 9 from 1. So now what will be the next step? Yes, we'll take 4 from the tens place. Then this 8 will become 7 and will give 110 to this one. And after taking 110 from here, this one will become 11. See, 1 was there and this tens place gave 110 to it. So 10 plus 1 is 11. So this is how we are writing 11 in the place of 1. Okay. So, now can we remove 9 from 11? Yes, now we can remove because now 9 is the smaller number. So, first of all, let us count 11 finger marks. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now we had counted 11 finger marks. Minus 9. Minus 9 is there, so we will take away 9 finger marks. 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now how many finger marks are left? 1 and 2. Only 2 finger marks are left. So we'll write the number 2. Okay. Now we are done with 1's column. So moving toward 10's column. So 7 minus 2. Can we remove 2 from 7? Yes, because 2 is a smaller number and 7 is bigger number. And we always subtract smaller number from the bigger number. So let us count 7 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now minus 2 is there. So we'll take away 2 fingers. 1 and 2. Now how many fingers are left? Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 fingers are left. So let's write the number 5. So 81 minus 29 is equals to 52. See, 81 total students were there. Out of them, 29 were boys. So how many were girls? 52 were girls. So let's write answer. There were 52 girls. Now you can note down. So now I hope all of you understood how to do subtraction problems, subtraction stories or word problems. Okay, now this all work you have to note down in classwork copy. Okay, so students, we will meet in next lecture. Till then, bye bye students, stay home, stay safe and keep practicing.